dangler.
You look like Baba Marley.
I do.
Yes.
Wait, can you get this? She's eating the cookies from the cookie.
We're stress eaters.
In the card he sent us, we can fill it with pictures from our honeymoon. And it says, began October 10th, 2013, official October 27th, 2013, continued August 26th, 2018. On this day, I marry my friend, the one I live for, laugh, live, and love.
Oh my god,
you're
so sweet. It's
alright.
To my best friend and very soon to be husband, I can't believe this day is finally here. Feels like forever ago we started planning, but it snuck up so quick. Can't imagine going through life without anyone but you. I know you will do anything and everything to make sure I am taken care of, including feeding me. I love this life we have built together, and I promise to do anything I can make sure you feel loved, supported, and needed. I've been so nervous about walking down the aisle in front of everyone, but the truth is, it's just you and me. I'm so proud to call myself your wife and your family. I'll see you forever, and I'll see you at 4:30. You soon to be wife.
You Joanna, to love you, care for you, and be there for you on good and bad days. You're my best friend and partner in crime. You make me a better person, and I cannot imagine a life without you. To grow old and wrinkly with you. To enjoy your home cooking and instant mashed potatoes. To tell you terrible jokes when you're feeling down. You're my world and my own. I love you with all my heart. I take you, Joanna, to be my wedded wife, to have and hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and cherish now and forever. You shall always see in my eyes the memory of this moment. I, Joanna, promise to you, my friend, to rub your back because I know it makes you happy. To let you watch all of your sports, even when the bachelor is on. Because I know you can. Friend, have more patience when you don't see eye to eye. I will always have your back. Put you first, be your number one fan, and your best friend. I'm so lucky to have found you, and so humble you chose me. I take you, Michael, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold this day forward. For better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, now and forever. You shall always see in my eyes the memory of this moment. I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
So aside from attaining a great education while she went to law school, she met this guy. By noon. And introduced me to him. And I gotta tell you, from the day that I met the guy, there was a spark that I saw. You never sat down without touching each other's arm or sitting close to one. And oftentimes, it'd be 10 people in the room, and there were two conversations. Everybody else and the two of them, they were like in their own little world. And it was, I can tell you what, it's something that any dad wants to see. I assumed that there was gonna come a day that they would get married, but you know, these things, you never know how it's gonna work out. But about a year and a half ago, I get a phone call. It was an email, and it was from Mike, asking me if I could find some time in my schedule to meet up with him. So I figured he was either going gonna pop the question, or he's gonna ask me for a loan. I really didn't know what he was. And he came to my home, I think that very day, because I was anxious. I think he was anxious too. And we had a beer. We bantered back and forth about, I don't even know, Red Sox, whatever we talked about, the Bruins, whatever it was. And finally, he said, so I bought a ring. And I said, well, he said, I really want to talk to you about it. I loved him, because he was just, I saw how happy that he made me. And so I like instantaneously said, okay. I then said, so does Joanna like the ring? He said, he hasn't seen it. He doesn't know. I said, well, is Joanna like really nervous that you're here today talking to me and looking for my approval? He said to me, she doesn't know. I said, well, what do you mean? He said, I wouldn't talk to her about it until I had your approval. This was in the 21st century, guys. Right? That's something out of the 19th century. The respect that I get from this kid, unbelievable. At the end of the day, when we finished up and he had to head out because he had to get back home before she found out that he was with me, he said to me, all I care is about is making Joanna happy. Well, you gotta know how that made me feel. I knew that she either had Eddie Haskell, and I was the Ward Cleaver, taking advantage of, or he's maybe the greatest guy for my little girl. I lift my glass to the two of you. May the love that you feel today between each other pale in